2015 to 2017, retired Rear Admiral John Kirby served as the U.S. State Department spokesman, the person responsible for explaining the United States' complex U.S. foreign policies to the world press and responding to reporters' challenging questions. It's a difficult job and a tough audience, but John won the respect of the notoriously skeptical press corps with his candor, knowledge, and integrity. From 2013 to 2015, John served as chief spokesman for the Department of Defense and the Pentagon Press Secretary, Under Secretary of Defense Chuck Hagel.
To achieve the level of success that John Kirby achieved requires a tremendous amount of commitment, dedication, and integrity. In my service, we always say integrity first.
John comes from a family with a long military history dating back to the Revolutionary War and the Civil War. John's father, the late Charles Chuck Kirby, served as a machinist mate in the Navy. Each of Chuck's five sons devoted at least a few years to the military at their dad's behest, and sister Pat worked as a VA hospital nurse. After graduating St. Petersburg Catholic High School, John hoped to attend the Naval Academy. But despite a strong high school record, including varsity letters in three sports, he wasn't accepted. As fate would have it, John enrolled at the University of South Florida, and his USF degree in history eventually led to an even better opportunity at the Academy, teaching naval history.
John could have gone to graduate school in history, and he would have made a fine professor. Unfortunately for us in the Academy, John chose a military career. In retrospect, academia's loss was the Navy and our country's gain.
John has loved history since reading his first chapter book, a children's biography of Naval Commander John Paul Jones. But he enrolled at USF as a biology major with plans to become a physician. The sciences, it turned out, weren't his strong suit.
He understood, I think, what we try to teach in the department then and now, which is critical thinking, which is analysis, which is interpretation, which is writing skills.
He was commissioned into the Navy in 1986 and qualified as a surface warfare officer aboard the USS Aubrey Fitch. The same year, he spotted a fellow Navy officer candidate, civil engineer Donna Drago, from a bus. 4 months later, the two eloped. After they had their first child, Megan, John began exploring his Navy career options. Life aboard a warship had lost some of its appeal.
What a tremendous career. Started out as a public affairs officer aboard many ships. Went on from there to be a spokesman for the Navy Blue Angels. And then went from there straight to the top.
During his time in the nation's limelight, John's mother, Eleanor, a real estate saleswoman who'd stay up until 3 a.m. to polish his high school term papers, proved his best critic. "You explained Russia well, but you're using your hands too much," she'd text after a televised press briefing. Now a military analyst for CNN, John is celebrating his 30-year anniversary with Donna this year. Daughter Megan is a stay-at-home mom with the Kirby's first grandchild, and son Colin is an officer candidate in the Navy ROTC at North Carolina State. A history buff who got the opportunity to witness history in the making, John credits everyone but himself for his success. His USF history professors taught him to think critically. Retired Rear Admiral Mike Mullen, former chair of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and his wife Deborah gave him room to grow while helping him stay grounded. John calls it falling into opportunity. USF calls it excellence. Please join us in congratulating 2017 distinguished alumnus, Rear Admiral John Kirby.